I keep my pants tucked with the pieces wide. Wide open all the time. I keep the end out for the tide to find. Because you're mine. He's full of twine. Well, as many of you already know, our book, Me, the Mob, and the Music, that came out a few years ago, is going to be turned into a movie. And we are just so flattered and grateful. Can't hardly believe it. And so it's fun watching it all come together. Actually, the story of Me, the Mob, and the Music is, the book is essentially an autobiography with about three-quarters of the book devoted to our very crazy, tumultuous, and sometimes scary relationship with Roulette Records, the label that we had most of our hits on. And the reason it's scary and tumultuous is because, unknown to us, when we were signing with Roulette back in 1966, Roulette, in addition to being a functioning indie label, and a pretty good label at that, was also a front for the Genovese crime family in New York. Of course, that made life really interesting for us. And we didn't know this when we signed. We learned things incrementally. The head of Roulette Records, Morris Levy, was sort of a notorious individual. And he would bring these guys up to Roulette, and they loved hanging up there, sort of like a social club. And we'd meet somebody in Morris's office, and a week later we'd see him on TV. He had taken out of a warehouse in New Jersey and kind of a dead giveaway. We just met in Morris's office. And that kept happening. So gradually we came to understand who we were dealing with. And but the strange part was that we had great success on Roulette. Of course, getting paid was like taking a bone from a Doberman. That's just what crime doesn't pay, you know? So, at any rate, we basically had to decide what to do, and we decided to stay, stick it out, and it probably was a good idea, because we would have never had the success if we had gone with one of the corporate labels that we could have gone with, like CBS or Atlantic or RCA. And the reason would have been because there was so much competition at these other labels. You know, at Roulette, they actually needed us and hadn't had a hit in almost 3 years. So they rolled out the red carpet for us. Well, this is sort of a long way of getting to the next song, which is going to be the closing credits to the film. And the last scene of the movie, I sort of have just kind of an imaginary conversation with Morris Levy. He died, by the way. He died of cancer in 1990 after he was convicted and sent to prison for 10 years. He died before he could serve a day. And so, at any rate, we have this imaginary conversation, and the credits start rolling, and this song starts playing. And it's a very different version of a song that we had a hit with many years before, and I thought we would play it for you tonight. It's slowed down, and it's, well, it has a lot of meaning in the movie at that moment, and I hope you do. They don't understand. So we're going as fast as we can, holding on to each other's hand, trying to get into the night, and you put your arms around me.
Is he on?